Top of this fine morning to you, Diesel.
Morning.
We're here in somewhere in North Carolina. Kenley, North Carolina, right? Is that what the logs say? Yeah, Kenley, North Carolina. That's where we're at. And we're just getting up. We just got all our paperwork sent into work for the border crossing so that we're ready to cross into Canada. Look, I'm even wearing a toque. Yeah, it's the warmest toque I have right now, so... Though I don't really need it because it's like really hot outside. So I don't know why I'm wearing it. But anyways, first thing this morning, we've got to do our pre-trip and whatnot, right? And it's a little different opening my hood now. I'm going to show you how you open the hood with the bumper on the front.
Well, on our way. I'd love to get over into that right lane there, but the four-wheelers apparently don't want me in the proper lane. They'd rather leave me in this lane. I tried putting the signal device on to ask permission to move over to the right, but they, I don't know, maybe they speak a foreign language. They don't understand the blinker. Let's try again. There we go. Now we got some blinker speakers. Thank you very much. You have no idea how long I was trying to get out of that lane. Anyway. That's the way to start the vlog. In the wrong lane. As soon as we get out of this populated urban area here, there's lots of traffic merging on and off the freeway here. As soon as we get past all these off-ramps and on-ramps,
keep left onto I-40 West.
And as soon as Mandy stops interrupting me, I'm gonna move over one lane yet. But seeing as there's four lanes here right now, trucks are allowed in the three right ones here. And this lane might actually be ending off to my right here, according to this sign, in Durham. Oh, okay, well then never mind. I'm not gonna move over one more lane. I am in the right lane. Ha! Smarter than you thought, Trucker Josh. I'm already in the right lane. Okay. You never know when you have so many lanes, you sort of just pick one and give her. As long as you're not in the left lane.
Moose bumper with what's called the slam latch. It pretty much makes it really easy just to click it up, like you pull up the pin, bumper comes down, you push back up, clicks in. Herd messed up my order and built it without the slam latch. So it's a little harder to open and close it, but they gave me a discount and I wasn't too happy about it, but I wasn't gonna wait another 2 months for them to build me another one because I'm not that picky. I can take an extra 30 seconds opening my hood every morning, I don't care. It's a disappointment. But I can't do. They gave me a discount, so they made it right, sort of. They offered to make me a new bumper for free. They offered, so it's not like they didn't try to make it completely right. Right? Herd is a great company. They make good bumpers. I'm not saying anything against them. They did try to make it right, and I said no, it's fine. I'll just keep this bumper, whatever. So I'll show you how I open this. So it's really quite simple. You see here on the front of the bumper, there's these. You know, two little hoopy-doop things. You take this pin that's in here,
now you got a pin. Stick it in there, this pin, and you unscrew it, right? Lefty loosey. This is really hard to do with one hand. See how it turns? Same thing on this side. Ah, this is hard to do with one hand. There we go. And now we'll just keep the pin down here for now. And you just unscrew them the rest of the way. And I can do this a lot faster with two hands. Obviously, it's taking a little longer because I'm holding you guys in one hand here. Okay. Once that's done, you gotta take the pin out of there, which it is. You simply pull it down like that. And then from there, you can open the hood, right? I already undid that side. Looks kind of funny like that, I know. Let's see this here. I just hop in right in here. And then put my foot on there. Pull back on here. And there you go. And your hood's open. You can check your oil, whatnot. Do your pre-trip and everything. So usually that goes a lot faster, but I've never done that with one hand before, so I just accomplished something I've never done before. That's the only way to get it open. I'm just working on my wipers here a little bit, trying to get the washer fluid to squirt a little better, because we're gonna be going up into the snow, making sure the wipers are good to go. Might as well do this while I'm down here, right? Check the oil and everything else while I'm underneath here. It's nice and warm down here. It is nice. Don't mean to make you jealous or anything, but are you jealous? This is for everybody back home shoveling snow. I'm wearing a t-shirt. I could even put shorts on if I wanted to. Look at this. Leaves are still on the trees. They're changing colors and whatnot, but the grass is still green. Isn't the weather great here, man, or what? Isn't it great? No, it's very nice, man. Very, very nice. Why don't you hold your head up? Hey! Hey! Hey!
Hold me?
Hey, you, man. Hold your head high. Get your sniffer in the air, man. Be proud, you're the weasel.
Pride does come before a fall. You're a humble lord.
Got respect. Respect for that. Absolutely.
Guess I could learn a few things from him. So I'm walking out of the truck stop, right? Now I'm just stretching out, enjoying the warm weather, got my t-shirt on, just happy to be alive. This lady comes out behind me, just yelling at her kid, "Let Johnny get your jacket on! Get your jacket on! You're gonna catch yourself a death of cold! Get your jacket on! It's cold out here, Johnny!" I stop, turn around. She wasn't yelling at him in a mean way. I'm just like, obviously giving her that look. And I have this big Canada toque on, right? And I tried my best not to laugh, but I know they could see a smile because they look at me, they look at my toque, and they sort of smiled. So I think they understood what I was getting at. It's like, it's seriously like 60 degrees outside. What is it? Let's see here. I'm guessing it's probably about 10, so it's about 50. 50 degrees outside. And there's another guy behind me. I'll show you this. I'll show you this. They got their kid like dressed up for minus 40 degree weather. Are you gonna see him in the mirror? Look at their kid. They have... What? Oh, they set off the alarm. He puts his son on the hood of the car. it sets off the alarm. The kid's running. Mommy, mommy. Seriously, they have this kid bundled up like it's minus 30 outside. The poor kid's gonna overheat. What a happy little family, though. That's good to see. A happy family.
Diesel. Isn't it nice to see happy families like that?
I saw them playing inside the store with him, and he was letting him stand on the counter. And the kid just felt like a boss, right? Because he's standing on the counter, and his dad's going, "Man, you're on top of the world, man. You're on top of the world." He's like, "I'm on top of the world." He's his little kid dad. But he's dressed like an Eskimo. And it's hot out, man. Oh, well. At least they care. At least they care, right?
What do you think of that, Diesel? You already asked me, man. Why do you keep asking me that? I don't think much. I'm a dog. Unless you talk about squirrels. We could talk about squirrels all day. Just so you know, I just farted. I can smell that. Thanks. Thanks for that.
Well, you know where we are? We're going behind a big, big store. Should have known that we're at Walmart. Jeez, people. So, we came in the truck entrance, and I saw a bunch of trucks parked on the other side in the parking lot, so I'm gonna park with them. But I came back here, because I knew I could for sure get back here, right? And I think I'm just gonna turn around and go back out to where those other trucks are. So I can get around the back on that side, but here's one of these Walmart trucks here right now. So you always know if he can get in here, I can get in here, right? That's why you always know you're safe going into a Walmart. They even have signs posted saying truck entrance this way. I think those chicks thought that I'm delivering here because they didn't look happy to see me. Don't worry. I'm not causing more work for you. Look at that house up there, eh? That is awesome. We are in West Virginia. Beckley, West Virginia, at the Super Center. It's a Super Center. It's not just a regular center. It's a Walmart Super Center. This is where super things happen. I hear Superman even shops here. Unconfirmed, but... okay, so there's lots of trucks parked over there on the other side. I gotta figure out how to get there. I'm guessing I gotta take the road there. I'm guessing they don't want me to go over the curbs. So if they got there, I know I can get there, right? Gotta figure out how to get there now. I'm gonna turn right at the stop sign, if I can. Okay, we're gonna turn right here. Oncoming traffic doesn't have a stop sign, but there is no oncoming traffic, so we shall make our move. Diesel, get down. I need my mirror. Good boy. Good boy. Just hits the deck. I love that. I trained him so that when I say get down, he doesn't just, you know, meander his way down. He, boom, hits the ground.
Yes. Yes. That zoom is so slow.
Diesel. What you got on your face there, man? What's on your face? It's my halter, man. Stops me from pulling.
Very true. Very true. Well, I'm going to walk in here with my Canadian toque. And walk around and do my thing. Just like this. I'm going to walk in there like this. And I'll try to convince them that that's how all Canadians walk. Just walk. Think they'll believe? No, they won't.
Oh, you are just dying to go outside, aren't you?
He's got that gaze.
Only like a week, man, and I'm gonna be running in the meadows with Lucy. I can't wait.
So true. We're gonna be at Jade and John's. What is today? Today is the 22nd of November, 2014, when I'm filming this.
Oh, so actually when you're watching this, I am there. It's already been over. I've already been and gone probably.
Because I got to be in Georgia on the Monday for you. So I need to, I'll probably be in the truck then already. On the way there, so.
Diesel, when they're watching this, you've already had your run in the meadow with Lucy. Are you going to have the guts to ask John?
Well, I don't know.
You're going to have to ask him, man. You have to be a gentleman. I raised you right.
Look at him, he's just nervous. I'm starting to sweat a bit, man, now that you mention that.
We'll see what happens. Anyways, I'm going to walk the weasel here right now. We're going to go into Wally World over there and, you know, live the dream. I'll walk in there. I'll want to buy everything. And I'll walk out. Probably with almost everything. Hopefully not. I don't have enough money this time. I put all my money away into savings. And I told you, right, that I opened an RRSP, which in Canada, I think it's sort of like a 401k. I think. I can't really tell you for sure, but it's a retirement savings plan. It stands for Registered Retirement Savings Plan, right? Anyways, it's a retirement plan, and they're taking a certain amount off my check, every check, and putting it in there. And whatever money I put in there, say I put like $100 in there this month, right? I cannot touch that $100 for 12 months, at least. So it makes it harder for me to get at, right? So every check, I put a certain amount of money in there and I can't touch that money for 12 months after I put it in. Does that make sense? But really, I'm not hoping I never ever need to touch it. The reason I didn't lock it in completely is for emergencies and whatnot, you know. You never know. As a truck driver, I'm traveling around. Trucks are expensive, you know. And if I need a new engine or a rebuild, it goes into the like, tens of thousands of dollars so quickly. And it's nice to know that I might be able to have access to that if I have to, but you never, ever want to dip into your retirement fund. Ever. Ever. But, you know, life happens sometimes, and sometimes, you know, you need the money. The reason I'm starting to put away, I wish I would have started sooner. You young guys out there, as soon as you start working, as soon as you turn 18, as soon as you move out on your own, as soon as you can legally get in a retirement plan, get a savings account going, put it away where somewhere where you can't get at it. Don't get a debit card that you can yank money out of there every time you feel like buying the latest movie at Walmart. Like I'm walking into Walmart here, and I have to admit, I'm a bit of an impulse buyer. That's why I know myself, and I make sure that I only have access to a set amount of money. And the rest of my money, I can't access. I have to make a few phone calls and get money transferred and blah, 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 blah. So it's just a couple of extra steps that deters me from, you know, gives me a chance to think about it. You know what? Maybe I don't need this movie right now. Maybe we can wait till payday, right? I don't want to make all these phone calls and go out of my way. A lot of the times, like now when I stop, well, the banks are closed at home anyway. So even if I wanted to call in and buy something and use that money, well, no one's there. It's closed. So that's good. Man. Start saving for retirement, guys, because in Canada we have what's called the CPP. Comes off every check. It's a government savings plan, pretty much. They automatically, mandatory, take it off your check for retirement. It's called the Canadian Pension Plan. And so when you retire, the government pays you this money back, right? It's a very, very liberal idea, but it's a good idea, you know. But being a conservative that I am, I believe that I should also be taking care of myself and not relying on my government so much. Because who knows if that money's even going to be there when I retire? Who knows what's going to happen in the next 50 years? Like, this world is going down the drain in a lot of places. And I'm not going to get all political on you because I could go on and on and on and on. My close friends that I talk to regularly, if they don't want to talk about this stuff, they know not to bring it up because I will not stop. So I'll stop myself now before I begin. But that's why I believe always try to put something away separate from your government savings plan because you never know what the government's going to do with that money or if it's even going to be there for you.
I just love the feeling of walking towards Walmart knowing I'm going inside to buy something. Not too sure what exactly yet, but we're working on it. the size of these apples here. It's huge. Everything is just ginormous in the States. Huge.
I like how you can see that Christmas tree.
So technically we're walking to Trucker Josh right now. Walking, we're slowly meandering our way over there. You remember when I was here? I was here in the summertime. This is the Ohio Turnpike. Remember we sat here listening to trucks drive by for a while on the freeway?
Whoa!
I almost fell on my face. Some Canadian I am. First little bump of snow and I fall on my face. Dud! Spending too much time in the south, I'm not used to this white stuff. Or that brown stuff. Full of salt. Oh, listen. It's beautiful. We got some chicken lights parked over there way in the back too. It's been a good day. Solid day. Drove about 10 hours, I think, something like that today. We ended up in Broadview. Oh, I'm pointing it at me. Broadview Heights, Ohio. We're at the service plaza here, and it's a little bit windy. I'm trying to keep you guys out of the wind. There you go. You gotta hide you behind the tree. See, there's a tree. The wind's coming from over there. But yeah, it's been a good day, I think.
Oh man, I spent too much time on my phone again. I parked there and I got sucked into my phone for like an hour and I already had a headache. And now I got like a super duper headache. Oh, you know, I should know by now to avoid certain things because they just give me a headache. But you know, I always go back and I get sucked into it. Oh well, what can you do?
Are you done, Diesel? Are you done already? Itchy face.
Look at that nice yellow peat there, eh? Very nice.
See, other than that, guys, I'm a little bit tired and I have a headache. So I'm gonna leave it here and say, if you can hear me through the wind, come check out my channel tomorrow at 4 a.m. Central Time. There'll be another video. Diesel will be there, I promise. That guy will not, however. Oh, I can't promise that. We might pass him tomorrow in the video. I don't know. But he's leaving. He's on a mission to go somewhere. No idea who that was. But guys, tomorrow, 4 a.m. Central Time, you'll be able to find me again in my next video. If you go down below to the description, you'll find the link that'll lead you to my uncle's fundraiser, who we're raising money for his treatment for MS. You can go read his whole story there if you haven't already. And thank you very much to all of you who have helped. We really appreciate it. It means a lot to us. Now you'll find links to my past videos, all kinds of stuff. If you go down to the show more button, I'll see you tomorrow.